Still continuing on day four. Almost wrapped up getting those purlins up. Man, these purlins, they're a little under 2 foot on center, so it's a lot of bolts and stuff. But so what I did, or what we're doing now, that wall back there is already pretty much plumb and square. This wall is not. You probably can't see it in the picture or in the video, but all four of these columns are leaning over, probably close to 2 inches at the top. No big deal. We knew that when we started setting them. Now we're gonna fix it. I've taken all of the rod brace and went ahead and made sure that I have everything snugged up, not tight, still a little bit loose, because we're gonna be doing some quite a bit of movement here. But I made sure that all of the hillsides, and this is obviously smaller, but even the big ones, they have this lip on them. So when they come into the frame, that lip connects with the frame. So I've got all those set, everything snugged up. And what we're gonna do is start tightening, because the frame needs to come over to our right. And we can tell by looking at the level, it's gonna be quite a bit off once we get up there to the top. So in order to fix that, we're gonna start using the bottom base and pulling over. We'll go back and forth from this bottom to that bottom as we bring both over. When you're checking level, especially on a three plate like this, or a welded I-beam that we've made in the shop, we don't want to check level off of the web. There's some variance in the machine and there's a tolerance allowed, but not with the flange. So the flange is always going to be straight. So we want to check with the outside flange, and we don't want to check with the inside flange, because this is a tapered frame. It's got a slight taper to it, so we just want to be on the outside. And also, if we're checking plumb in and out of the building, we want to be on the outside flange, never on the inside. And this one is pretty darn close. On a wide flange beam, the two corner columns of this are wide flange beams, so those are mill beams. So on a wide flange, we can measure up, we can hold plumb off of the web. Like I said, we're going to start tightening from the bottoms. I've set all the tops to where I want them, especially on the outside, because we don't want that bolt going through past the steel line where it'll interfere with panel. So we're gonna do all of our tightening down at the bottom. And we're gonna start, like I said, we're gonna start with this one, then we'll move over to this one, and we'll check it. If we want some more movement, we'll come back here, and we'll come back here, and then we'll move up to the top here and here. And as we pull it over, it's going to slacken the other side. And that's fine. Even if those hillsides pop off, it's easy to go back up there and reset them. In order to move this, the base plates are fairly snug. Since we want the column to come this way, we're gonna loosen these two bolts on this side. And what we're gonna try to do is only loosen the inside of the right side. You would think just by loosening these, we'd get the column to move. It's like a half inch or a 5/8 inch base plate. And if these bolts are snug, it's even though it's off of the center, it's gonna hold that plate down. So I'm gonna, because I like where it is in and out, I'm gonna try to leave that one on there. We might just take a little bit of tension off of it, but I know for sure I need to loosen these three. And probably, we'll see, probably gonna have to loosen those. And we're gonna do that on all three of these, on all four of the columns as we bring it over. That way we're not binding or bending the steel to get it to come plumb. Once that's done, we'll check our gap from the outside and see if we need to place any shims underneath. I imagine that we will, but we're probably only gonna move about 1/16 of an inch, maybe even less. So a shim might not be necessary. Just 1/16 down there is gonna move the top of this thing a lot. So, all right, we're gonna get to it.